The main role of CERT in the project is to provide data services and advanced analytics related to the control and monitoring of all the demo sites. This subject matter is also integrated in the subject of my PhD, which is entitled Design and Control of Energy Storage Systems. When talking about energy storage systems, renewable energy sources are often the main source of power to those systems, and is also the reason why energy storage is imperative in the first place, because this is the most efficient way to deal with their volatile power supply. In the scope of both the project and my PhD, we are formulating model-based control strategies, which are demo-specific and are going to be tested in a simulation environment during the course of the project. The results of these tests will be analyzed in terms of efficiency, system resilience, and general performance in order to have a benchmark analysis of the scalability of the algorithms and their applicability to different scenarios. A comparison between the implemented control strategies in each demo and the formulated strategies by us will be made to assess the efficiency of the designs and also to assess the improvements, if any could be made, that would be mandatory to in order to achieve an almost 100% renewable power supply and 0% dependence on fossil fuels or a grid connection. Also, in my PhD, we try to implement different control strategies for as many storage technologies as possible. Up until now, the core technologies that are involved are electrochemical storage in the form of hydrogen and batteries, pumped hydro storage, and also thermal storage. Our goal is to study real-life applications of all the technologies involved, whether they are demonstrations, commercial applications, or industrial applications, so that we are able to analyze the operation based on real data, adding another layer of interest in the context of my thesis. Moreover, the control algorithms are built to be applicable to very diverse case studies in terms of size. Sometimes we deal with demands of a few kilowatts and sometimes some megawatts. In terms of the renewable energy source, it could be either solar, wind, or hydroelectric, and many other aspects like location, storage capacity, and access to the electricity grid. Nowadays, with climate change being the hot topic globally, power production is undergoing drastic changes, transitioning from a past where abundant resources were available and there was no need to optimize anything, to the present and future where resources are no longer abundant and the operation of the systems that use them must be controlled optimally to ensure the optimal usage of resources and avoid wasting them. As the number and complexity of power systems is increased, the need of having smart control frameworks is becoming imperative. The digitalization of information and data has enabled the use of smart control techniques to a very wide range of applications. Systems like the remote demos are becoming more and more popular because renewable energy sources are going to dominate the power production market in the future and also now. But this is not the only case. Smart control techniques could be applied to systems powering buildings, powering transport with hydrogen or electric vehicles, or even systems powering appliances. Wherever optimal power distribution to complex subsystems is needed, or the optimal use of resources is required, the knowledge acquired from the project could serve as a replicable base to be implemented to all the cases I just mentioned. Specifically for the second demo in Agistro, in Greece, the power system there has the role to supply energy to a tertiary building. In general, power systems like the ones installed in remote, except from supplying cheap renewable energy and helping decarbonizing the power supply, avoiding fossil fuel usage. These demos have also another role and that is as an educational tool for all the for in, as an educational tool for all the population that specifically in Greece there are still some oppositions against the renewable energy sources and also hydrogen batteries. People are not really educated about these matters. So the demo in Agistro is going to serve as an educational tool to promote the usage of renewable energy sources and also connect the people